Well, we're going to bring in somebody from the top 1% and we're going to talk to them. Peter Schiff is a successful businessman. He's made apparently $64 million. He ran for Senate in Connecticut. And we had you on the program on the Young Turks when you were running, Peter, I remember. I'm glad to have you back. You went down to Occupy Wall Street, and you started a debate with those guys. One, what the world were you thinking? And two, what is your
point against the 99%? Apparently, I have to now do the same thing with you guys. You know, you can't paint the 1% with that banker brush. Yeah, there are some people in the 1%, the vast minority of the 1%, who got rich off of government bailouts and from the Fed. And that ought to stop. And you ought to direct your outrage at the Federal Reserve, out of the U.S. government. They're the ones that are funding all this. I wanted to let the banks fail. I wanted to let people lose their jobs. And you have to remember, the financial crisis had its roots in bad monetary and fiscal policy and bad regulatory policy. Some of these bankers were involved, but it was the government that led them to it.
All right, so Peter, a couple of things there. Number one, you say you got to blame the bankers. Well, I couldn't agree more. I didn't quote Steve Jobs. I didn't go after Bill Gates. I didn't even go after Warren Buffett. None of these guys, okay? So it's not an attack on the rich.
Well, Warren Buffett got bailed out too, you know. He was a big shareholder.
Well, that's actually true.
He got bailed out.
That's actually true. That's a good point.
He got a lot of bailout money.
That's not a bad point either. And his ratings companies are a disaster and led to some of this collapse as well. But we don't go after just rich people. I quoted all the people in the financial industry, people like Jamie Dimon who took money, plus the guys from the Home Depot who say, oh, yeah, the average guy should pay more taxes than me. I should get a 15% rate on capital gains, dividends, and carried interest. That's a crime, man, to have the richest people in the country pay 15%. How do you justify that?
Well, most of them aren't. I agree with you that we shouldn't have a preferential rate for hedge fund managers. I think we should get rid of the carried interest, but I'd like to get rid of the income tax for everybody. But as it stands right now, I am paying a fortune in income taxes. I'm paying, if you add all the taxes I'm paying, about half the money I earn is being paid in taxes. I don't qualify for that 15% rate because I don't earn my money that way. And the vast majority of people in the 1% are paying enormous rates of taxation. And not only is this unfair and immoral, but because taxes are so high, fewer businesses are created, fewer jobs are created, fewer goods
are
produced.
Are you talking about
and
taxes?
Everybody suffers, especially the members of the 99%.
No, that's simply not a fact. That's not true. Taxes are at an all-time low.
No, they're not. You're just totally wrong.
The effective tax rate is the lowest it's been. It's certainly since the 1950s, I believe all the way back to the 1920s.
No, it's not. You're completely wrong.
All right, well, you know, we'll do fact-checking. We'll have political fact or
somebody looking into it. Income taxes at all because
you're totally not correct.
And, you know, the average American didn't pay income taxes until 1943 when we had the withholding taxes. But there was a period of time, the 1950s and 1960s, 70s, where tax rates were higher. But people didn't pay those rates. It was so easy to get deductions that few people were paying those taxes.
All right,
the vast majority of income was taxed at a much lower rate back in the 1950s and 60s than it is today.
No, okay. Let me clarify on two things.
You're wrong.
And, no, you're wrong, but we'll get independent people to check it out.
I'm not wrong.
Okay, all right, listen,
you know,
we can keep yelling back and forth about who's
right
wrong.
Now.
Let me just state some of the facts, and then I want to ask you about your central premise, okay? First of all, the taxes were lower at 28% at one point at the very end of Ronald Reagan's term, right? So as a percentage for the highest bracket. But for most of our history, taxes have been actually until the 1980s were in the 70 to 90% range.
No, first of all, that's not most of our history. There was no income tax at all.
No, I'm saying the time that we have had income tax. And second of all, the effective tax rate is as low as it's ever been right now, certainly since the 1950s. All right, we disagree on that. We will have people look into it. I want to go into your central premise. I want to go to your central premise.
Losses from one business against your wages. You can't do that now. We don't have the types of deductions that we used to have.
Peter, we have to move on from that because you're wrong and you keep insisting. So let's move on. So, Peter.
If you think people are actually
paying, I want to go to your central premise. You are dead wrong. Please stop talking about things you're not right about.
If the government was going to take 60 or 70% of his income. He wouldn't. No, I wouldn't do it.
Peter, I got to ask you the last question about your central premise. You say that it is the government that is the problem because they're the ones that give out the money to the bankers, et cetera. You say you're against the bailouts. But why do you think the government does that? You think they want to just help the bankers out of the goodness of their heart? No, because they're bought by the bankers. For example, President Obama, his largest donor is Goldman Sachs. Every single one of these guys takes a huge amount of money from the bankers.
But if you want to stop take the power away from the politicians.
Peter, you've got to let me finish.
As long as they have power, people are going to line up to buy it. Take away the power. And
so
the other
are you saying
that the
bankers are not guilty of this at all?
And spending
so
and
isn't the
so
problem that the
that
bankers...
The vitality of the free market. Okay. We don't have the benefits of capitalism anymore because we don't have capitalism. We have a centrally planned socialist economy, and that is why the average American is getting poor.
If
we want to change
that circumstance, Peter, I'm done with you. No, you guys don't get it. I'm done with him. He's done. Move away from him. Okay, bring him down. He won't shut up. Okay, and he doesn't listen to facts. We will have, it's don't take my word for it, we will have an independent analysis of the effective tax rate today, and we will show you on our website on current.com/theyoungturks what the tax rate has been since the income tax began. And second of all, he wants to blame the government for the problems, but he knows it's his banker friends who have given those donations, who buy their senators, who buy their staff members so they can get more money. He doesn't want you to pay attention to that because that's how they rob you. And he comes on here and he will go, oh, no, it's socialism, socialism, my ass. The real problem is, and he's talked about this in the past, but he didn't talk about it there, corporatism, where the corporations come in and steal and rob us blind in exactly the way that I showed it. But he doesn't want you to know that because he wants to keep sucking the money out of the system. All right, we'll be right back on The Young Turks.